You may not know his name, but he's been in some of the best cult films from the 80s. Whether it be a wino or a window washer, this guy has made a living off of playing one role. Today on the internet, we're taking a look at one of the most enormous bums in Hollywood, George Buck Flowers, and the long career he had in the business.
Action!
Action, Buck.
George Buck Flower acted for over 35 years. And in those three decades, he was involved in over 150 different films. When he first started in the 70s, he would take roles in films that can only be safely described on the internet as hillbilly exploitation films. Seriously, movies back then were more adult than they are today. And while we have Magic Mike and 50 Shades of Grey, they had movies like Country Cousins and Mother Knows Best, where he plays Boris Klitoris, and these type of films were coming out every other week. But it wasn't just adult films for Buck. He also got small parts in action movies like The Daring Dobermans, which is a film about dogs that rob a bank.
It works! The Daring Dobermans. It's entertainment that the entire family can enjoy together.
Buck also got a more prominent role in the science fiction film The Alpha Incident, where he plays a drunk train conductor.
What do you mean, Mr. Sorensen? What is this thing?
And more kid-friendly films like The Adventures of the Wilderness Family, which got two sequels. George was a steady worker, and by 1979, he had almost 60 films on his resume, and he was just getting started. At the beginning of the 1980s, he was cast in the new John Carpenter film, The Fog, where he played a sailor at sea that becomes a victim to the vengeful spirits. But as quick as his death was in the movie, it wasn't the end of his work with John Carpenter. John would go on to cast George again to perform what he does best, a bum, in his new film, Escape from New York.
The high adventure of the future. One man must...
At this point, George had nailed his grizzled look, and it caught the attention of one of the biggest directors in town, Robert Zemeckis. Robert was looking for the perfect person to look homeless on a bench for his new film, Back to the Future, and there was no better actor to cast. After Back to the Future, George would go on to work alongside Lance Henriksen in Pumpkinhead, as well as the movie Mac and Me, where he played a security guard.
In front, please. Buck, get up here.
What is that?
I don't know. Get him out of here.
All right. Now you put that down right now.
In 1988, George would go back to work with John Carpenter for his next film, They Live, where he would star in one of his most famous roles, a drifter. But not just any drifter, a drifter who sells out.
How you doing, boys? I didn't know you'd been recruited. Welcome aboard.
Earth is our stepping stone for a
drifter. You know, you boys really should have dressed for the party. Now you can afford it.
He would go back to play Red the Bum one more time in Back to the Future Part 2 before stepping into the 1990s. By this time, George had acted in another 30 movies, and 5 of those, he played a bum, drunk, or some sort of homeless person. All this experience set George up for the next decade. And in the 1990s, he appeared in another 10 roles as some sort of homeless man, including my favorite, Mom, Can We Keep Her?, a movie where Reese from Malcolm in the Middle wants to get a pet so bad, he ends up with a 500-pound gorilla.
He just wanted a pet. But got so much more.
They won't let me keep a bulldog. You think they're gonna let me keep you?
An escape?
I don't know why, but the 90s had an obsession with primates. You had Dunstan Checks In, Ed, Born to Be Wild, Monkey Trouble, Mighty Joe Young, the list goes on. I don't know why it was like this, I just lived through it. But anyways. George would go on to work with John Carpenter again in his new film, Village of the Damned, where he played a janitor that gets bullied by the local teens, as well as an episode of Power Rangers in Space, where he played a bearded man, which clearly was homeless.
Maybe she's right. Maybe they have left us.
By the end of the 90s, he had appeared in another 39 movies and over 10 TV shows. George would continue working into the 2000s, showing up on a couple more episodes of Power Rangers and some made-for-TV movies. But in 2004, at the age of 66, George Buck Flower passed away from cancer. In the end, he acted in over 150 different films across 3 decades, with 21 of those roles being some sort of vagrant. He has worked with stars like Jeff Bridges, Michael Madsen, Christopher Reeves, Keith Davis, Orson Welles, Roddy Piper, Michael J. Fox, Chuck Norris, and even more. George Flower once said, "I've done that character so many times that when somebody says, 'Saw you play a drunk on a park bench,' I have no idea what movie they're talking about." I don't think a lot of people can say they have worked with John Carpenter and the Power Rangers, or get to tell people they made a living off playing a bum for the last 35 years, but George Buck Flower did. Let me know what your favorite George Buck Flower cameo was, as well as any primate movies you can remember from the 90s. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you on the internet.
See ya, boys.
Let's go!